Hi guys, I'm Christine from Bottom of the Box Beauty, and today I'm going to be unboxing the Tribe Beauty Box, or unbagging, I guess. It seems to come in a bag for me. Most of you, if you're following anything from Tribe Beauty Box, might have already seen everything. I think I got one of the last shipments out, but nonetheless, I would love to unbox with you and just kind of go over everything. In this box, there was one choice item, just two shades of highlighter, so doesn't matter, I bought the other one, so I'll show you both of them. And then I guess we'll just get right into it, but quick rundown, Tribe Beauty Box. Comes every 2 months, $39.99. You can get it a little bit cheaper if you buy it in like bunches of three or something like that. And it's five full-size products, and you're getting some indie brands in there, which is why I really like it. Okay. Oh, and it's female-owned, so it's great. I'm just gonna kind of dump everything out and then just... I almost dropped everything on the table. Okay. So, everything kind of looks like nothing's in the bubble wrap except for the card, which is interesting. Okay, so I'll just put it to the side unless it says anything. Okay, so first things first, the choice item there was a Nomad Cosmetics highlighter. So the two options were Sydney Bathers, or I forget what it's called, Around the World. One is more of like a bluey purpley, and the other one's more of orange champagne-y, I guess you could say. I couldn't decide between the two, and since I hadn't tried Nomad Cosmetics, and since we were able to buy it as an add-on there, and it was not too expensive, then I just bought both. Okay, I'm just gonna take them both out of the box there. I've seen so many good things about Nomad's eyeshadows. I've just never personally tried any of their, shadows, but. Okay, so here is the Nomad. It's Around the World. Okay, and it's, let me cover this up. So it's like a bluey, purpley, shimmery shade, which I would never, I don't usually, that's what it kind of looks like. I don't know if I would wear it, but I really wanted to see if I could. Ooh, it looks really cool. I wonder too, if you had it as like a topper, it's really hard to see. As a topper, let me just do a couple coats to see if I can make it really show up for you. A topper on a darker shadow. And that would be a cool eye look too, I think. The packaging is a little bit bulky for me, if I'm being picky. It's a bit hard to close. But the highlighter is really nice. Okay, and then the Sydney Bathers. So that's the mirror. I guess I keep it off. Yeah, the packaging was, as I was talking, the packaging. So it seems a little bit cheap to me, and then the mirror was there. But this highlight almost looks like a pinky, peachy tone. Kiss of Sun highlighter is something. Okay, so let me just get a lot on there. What's the other one? Put it back on my finger just so I can compare the two for you. So this is the purpley one, and this is the peachy one, you can see. Oh, well, that's stunning. Okay, both really pretty. So I still wouldn't be able to pick one right now. Maybe I would pick, if I had to pick one, guys, I would probably pick this one just because I have so many peachy ones, but they're really kind of weird to close. You have to get the angle right. And this one, I'll just glue the mirror back on. Okay. A couple things to try, not any of their fault, it's probably shipping. I've had a couple things come kind of damaged from them. That's okay. Okay, next up is this Suva Beauty, which I've received from them before, a glossy lamination liquid lipstick in the shade Fictional Reality. It looks like a plummy wine colored. I ruin everything I open. Okay. Plummy wine colored, I was saying, kind of shade it looks like. I had a red lip gloss from them before and it looked really, really nice. Ooh, this is pretty. I don't have a shade like this actually. Okay, so this is how it swatches. Okay, I'll try and put it on for you, but sometimes with darker shades, embarrassed. I'm just using my phone. It's really pretty. That's really nice. The last two I've got, then this and the red one, have been really well suited. That looked really nice on me, I thought, and it's really nice. Okay, really nice, really nice. Then we have some sheet masks, it looks like. We Glow, which I'm just reading on the back, is collagen and fruit extracts to give a divine dewy on the glow. It's got collagen, licorice, apricot, cucumber, and grapefruit. And this one is, on for 15 to 20 minutes. You're done. And then you have Pierlise, which I'm a big fan of some of their products. I've never tried their masks before. And this one is with coconut and rice sheet mask. Nice. And there's five things. So one, I always have to count, two, three. And then this one is Able Skincare, and it's a 3-in-1 glycolic acid molecular boost eye serum. I'm right now using the Able Night Recovery Cream, and I really like that one. I took a break from it to try some other products, but I really do like this one. I think though, because I do use a retinol-based eye cream, I don't think you can use glycolic acid and retinol together. I'd have to look it up. I always get confused with that. But I think you would have to use it every other day. If anyone else knows, just let me know. And then finally, so this is the one I've been looking forward to. It's the Totally Tubular palette from Lorella Cosmetics. So I tried really hard not to look at it because I wanted to be surprised by the shades, but I've seen a few glimpses of it. One of the boxes that I got, I also had a Lorella Cosmetics palette, and it was a sweetheart palette, so I've played around with that today, which is absolutely gorgeous. And you know, you sometimes forget about when you have so many, you forget what they're like, but they have some really nice shimmers. And there was one kind of duochrome one that I'm wearing now. I have no idea if you can see it or not, but they have nice shimmers, mattes, blendable, pigmented. So if this is anything like their other palette, then we're good to go. So this one is like an 80s theme. Okay. Ooh, there is some cool shades in here. Okay. Just block this. So this is really fun. Most of these shades I would say that I don't have. And it looks like it's an even mix almost of mattes and shimmers. So let's just swatch a couple for you. I'm gonna do Heather's, which is this blue one, and then I'll do this Material Girl, which, ooh, so smooth. Okay, so Material Girl, can't really see it as well, but it looks good. Heather's, look at that. And I'm gonna do a couple more. This one's called Reflex. It looks like it's just like a bluey gray with some glitter in it. Really pretty. These swatch really well. My hair on my lipstick there. And another one, Magnolias, another shimmer. It feels so nice swatching on. We're getting it too. So really pretty there. And then I'll do two mattes just to show you. So this one is called Molly. And then I'll do this one. I'm running out of fingers. This one called Mode. They feel very, very smooth. Very, look how pigmented that is. Look at that. I don't know why I skipped there. Lotion on my arm or something, but. So, I've got some awesome shades in there. I think you could do. Okay, I'm gonna do one more, Rhapsody, which looks maroon, but then it has these like gold flecks in it. I don't know if you can see it. Where's my on camera there? Like little gold flecks. Where can I go? A little streaky at the end there, but how nice they blend out. Really excited to use this. So let me just refer to the little sheet here so I can go over the prices if you're interested. So this is worth $29. The Nomad highlighters are $17 each, and I definitely paid at least half of that for this, the second one, so I thought that's worth it. This, I don't think it's a typo, but it says it's worth US $160. I would never spend that much money on an eye cream unless suddenly I looked like 5-10 years younger. That's really expensive. This sheet mask is worth $6, and so is the Peerless. It's worth $6. And the Suva Beauty lipstick is worth $18. So I paid $37, I believe, for it, because I get it in chunks of three. So I think it was definitely worth it for me. What I'm thinking of doing is actually just doing a look at all the eyeshadow palettes I've received from just Try Beauty Box on its own and kind of comparing them. I don't know if you're like me and you end up with so many different eyeshadow palettes that you kind of forget what you have, and then you open it and you look at what you have and you're all excited again, but I think I would like to do that. What do you think? What do you think this palette? Do you like this color on me? Let me know. I will post down below everything about the cost and then links to each of their things, to each of their sites. So thanks for watching and have a great day.